we'd like to share.
And Brother Rutherford would start to speak.
It is often said that religion is a snare and a racket. And why? Religion had its origin with Satan, who implored religion to reproach Jehovah, the Almighty God.
You know, many of us don't even like to look at a snake, let alone carefully study its personality and characteristics.
And Brother Rutherford, he'd always be busy writing. You wouldn't know what he'd be writing about.
Golden Age magazine.
Its purpose? To explain the meaning of world events and to inspire hope in the supreme remedy.
Did you know?
I'm not the man they think I am at home. Oh, no, no, no. I'm a rocket man. Rocket man, burning out his fuse out here at home. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time till touchdown brings me round again to find. Fact is cold as hell.
Did you know?
That was understood by some before, but not by the rank and file of the brothers.
Jesus called them serpents, offspring of vipers. Who is he talking about?
That damn Rutherford.
Because they were really worshipping the creature more than the creator.
From the beginning, Jehovah has always cared about people. Sadly, many of them have caused him great pain.
Buzzes by radio.
Joseph Rutherford.
Faithless. Refused to believe in and listen to God's Son. So Jesus exposed
Joseph Rutherford
for what they were and called them serpents because of the deadly spiritual
Joseph
harm
Rutherford
inflicted on others who were influenced by them.
I'm not the man they think I am at home. Oh, no, no, no. Rocket Man!
Up to 1908, the work had been directed from Russell's hometown, now a part of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. But to accomplish a more extensive international work, the headquarters, known as the Bible House, were far too small.
Did you know?
In 1908, Russell dispatched J.F. Rutherford and others to New York City to secure more suitable quarters. The place was named Bethel, meaning House of God.
Watch me unravel, I'll soon be naked.
Something very evil happened to you when you were a young boy. At the Watchtower headquarters in Brooklyn, New York. So what are you going to talk about, Mark, concerning this very disturbing moment as a young one in the Jehovah's Witness organization?
Okay, well, I have to preface everything by telling you that my mother and father both spoke, wrote, and read fluently the Finnish language, okay? And the Watchtower Society didn't have any Finnish-speaking people in Brooklyn. They had them at their branch office in Finland, but not in Brooklyn. And there was a lot of correspondence from Finland in the Finnish language. So, you know, extremely sensitive matters within the organization. And I remember my parents sitting there and translating it into English, and many times they had to take a trip down to Brooklyn Bethel. I would go with them. And they would be with the service department or the writing department, you know, doing a translation. And sometimes it was vice versa. They would give it an answer from the service department, and my parents would have to translate it into Finnish and send it off to this individual. So, anyway, while I was down there with them, on one occasion, I was out wandering around a little bit, and this man came to me, took me to his room, and he sexually molested me in Bethel. And for years, I didn't know his name. I did not know who he was, but I used to see him get up on a stage and give public talks and everything. And then, I was about 40, 45 years old, and somebody mailed me some photographs with the names. And there was Percy Chapman, Leo Greenlee's, and several others. I saw Leo Greenlee's picture, and I said, that's the man. Now I have a name to go with the face. And Percy Chapman was also kicked out of the Watchtower. Nothing was ever done to Leo Greenlee's. In fact, he was never disfellowshipped. They just shipped him out to the Midwest somewhere. And it was also on record that he had molested more than just me.
And I get real high, and I scream from the top of my lungs, what's nation. And I pray, oh my God, do I pray? I pray for single day, for revolution. Into a crisis of times when I'm lying in bed, just to get it all out, what's in my head. And I am feeling a little peculiar. Into a wake in the morning and I step outside and I take a dip of.
When I was a little girl, I was living in Los Angeles. He was the district servant. There are two boys. Their initials are MD and MW. If they, I could find them, they're older than me. They were there. There were witnesses. We were terrified into silence. We were not allowed to talk. My life was threatened, and my brothers were threatened they were going to be killed if I spoke. And when I started to remember the abuse, I was abused horrifically in the congregation, and I wrote the Watchtower Society, and I begged for help. And I have the letters with me to show you that they commended the elders who heard me, and they told me they could not answer any of the questions that I asked, nor could they comment on the circumstances which I described to the congregation. I ended up in the hospital in crisis in the emergency ward because of what the elders did to me. And then I was hospitalized for months because I had nowhere to go. I was homeless. They threw me out in the street. I was destitute and I was disabled. I was unable to work because of the flashbacks I was having. And I ended up on the street, and I have with me a photocopy of the letter that the elders, the entire body of elders, sent me. It has all of their names on it. It says that they called the Watchtower Society here in New York and asked for how to help me. And they sent me a list of homeless shelters, and I have a list of homeless shelters. One of them was Burnside Projects on Skid Row in Portland, Oregon. Two of them were churches. One was Care to Share, which is based in a Lutheran church in Beaverton, Oregon, and the other was the YWCA. The humiliation that I felt was beyond belief. I almost died when I got that letter from those elders, and I almost stopped praying. The Watchtower Society has stood as a block between children and their God. All they do is destroy a person's faith and hope and make us feel like God does not love us. And I'm here to say that He does. And I'm saying for those of us who are victims of satanic ritual abuse in this organization by some of these elders and by Ted Jarrett, it's safe to come out now, and you can come and talk. And I'm begging anybody who knows MD and MW, I would say their names, but for privacy, I won't reveal them. But Silent Lambs knows, and so I'm begging for MD and MW.
A culture of silence about child sex abuse within Woodland Park's Jehovah's Witnesses congregation. Tonight, a 60-year-old Florissant man is at the center of those allegations in jail, charged with 8 counts of child abuse. Investigative reporter Dan Beatty combed through court records today. He's live with us to explain what they reveal. Dan?
Tonight, Sean Swisher is in the Teller County Jail, accused of sexually abusing multiple children, but for decades, he was an elder at the Jehovah's Witnesses Kingdom Hall in Woodland Park. These records right here show that people inside the congregation were afraid they'd be kicked out if they came forward with child sex abuse allegations against Swisher.
When interviewed by Teller County investigators, witnesses said Sean Swisher was a, quote, trusted elder, and highly respected in the congregation. But the Jehovah Witnesses elder was also out of control. Teller County investigators list 8 separate victims of child abuse in Swisher's arrest report. More than a dozen people interviewed with detectives about Swisher's behavior when he was an elder inside the Jehovah Witnesses Kingdom Hall in Woodland Park. Among the allegations, Swisher would inappropriately touch or tickle children on their breasts, inner thighs, even grab their private parts. One victim alleges Swisher told them their parents were okay with him doing this and not to tell anyone after putting his hands down their pants. Multiple victims recall being molested, saying Swisher would, quote, tie up, torture, and sexually abuse in any way possible. Witnesses and victims told detectives that they were discouraged from going to authorities, and sex abuse allegations were always handled internally. One victim alleges an elder told them the punishment that God gave was worse than the punishment than men gave you. Several other elders and people associated with Swisher are named in the arrest report, accused of molesting and abusing children. Their names are redacted. The Teller County Sheriff's Office says there could be additional arrests stemming from this ongoing investigation.
13 investigators reached out to the Jehovah Witnesses headquarters in New York with questions about Swisher and their policies when it comes to reporting abuse. We're waiting on a response. Reporting in the studio, Dan Beatty, 13 investigators.
Those fingers in my hair, that sly come hither stare, that strips my conscience bare, it's witchcraft. And I've got no defense for it, the heat is too intense for it. What good would common sense for it do? 'Cause it's witchcraft, wicked witchcraft. And although I know it's strictly taboo,
Jehovah's Witness elder possesses a significant risk of tampering with evidence if released on bail. Liam Bland has more.
Rob, the Mooloolaba man was arrested yesterday and is facing 21 counts of rape and 17 counts of sexual assault. Police allege the 61-year-old, who's also charged with incest and torture, preyed on at least 4 young men over 10 years from 2008.
Just figure facing 21 charges of rape.
That's right, Melissa. The man was a senior member of the Jehovah's Witness community. He was arrested following a raid on his property. And some of these offences, well, they date back as far as 2008. Now, we understand that the alleged offences were committed against at least 4 victims. There are several charges, more than 30 in all. The 61-year-old has in total been charged with 21 counts of rape, 17 of sexual assault, 13 of procuring a sexual act.
When you arouse the need in me, my heart says yes indeed in me. Proceed with what you're leading me to. It's such an ancient pitch, but one I wouldn't switch, 'cause there's no nicer witch than you. And although I know it's strictly taboo, when you arouse the need in me, my heart says yes indeed in me. Proceed with what you're leading me to. It's such an ancient pitch, but one that I'd never switch, 'cause there's no nicer witch than you.
Be strangled to death. Their fangs, they bite deep, and their venom will creep inside you till you're gasping for breath. And you can't get away from these god-awful snakes. They will bite and suck till they bleed you dry. And when they're done with you, they'll be stalking someone new. Oh, trust me, you'll be lucky to survive. And they won't let you go, no! They're creepy, they're cold, so beware of the snakes in the grass.
Snakes in the grass.
They strike in a flash, so you better watch your ass or fall victim to the snakes in the grass.
I've
to move past when they're waiting, coiled and ready to strike. So you'd best be alert.
Their identity would be considered at a seven-day convention held in Columbus, Ohio in 1931. Attendees received programs with the puzzling letters JW on the cover.
Be mindful of their poisonous bite. And I won't let you go.
No!
They're creepy, they're cold. So
no.
Beware of the snakes in the grass.
Snakes in the grass.
They strike in a flash. So you better watch your watch. If I fall victim to the snakes in the grass. Be careful where you step. Cause I've been there myself. Beware of the snakes in the grass.
Not only that, but the term Christian itself became a misnomer. Many people said they were Christians and they didn't have any idea as to what a Christian meant.
Lies, lies, you're telling me that you'll be true. Lies, lies, that's all I ever get from you. Tears, tears, I shed a million tears for you. Tears.
Matthew 23, verse 33. He told them, "Serpents, offspring of vipers, how will you flee from the judgment of Gehenna?" Now, the judgment of Gehenna meant that if they did not change, they would be everlastingly destroyed.
Rutherford invited his listeners to face the facts.
Brother Rutherford would start to speak.
It is often said that religion is a snare and a racket. And why? Religion had its origin with Satan, who implored religion to reproach Jehovah, the Almighty God.
Raise your right hand, put your left hand on the Bible.
You solemnly swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God.